introduction break. We had stopped at the definition of empire. I want to look at something else, that is potential difference. Potential difference, which we term as PD, and the symbol is V. So how do we define this potential difference? We can define potential difference as the work done. I told you before that the word potential means work. I remember giving you a song of late, Mose. He sang a song of potential. It means the person had work. Potential difference means, and the word difference means you must have 2 points. Now, potential difference means work done to move a charge from one point to another in a circuit. If this is point A and this is point B, and you have a charge to be moved from point A to point B, so we shall say VAB is what you call potential difference. When I get work done to move a charge from point A to point B, that work done is none other than potential difference. And from, remember in electrostatics, we said work done equals to VQ. So it means V equals to work done out of charge. Now, work done is always measured in what? In joules. How about this one? In coulombs. Therefore, the SI unit is joules per coulomb. Now, 1 joule per coulomb, 1 joule per coulomb is equal to 1 volt. Therefore, the standard SI unit of this so-called PD is none other than volts. Students make mistakes whereby they say the SI unit is ampere and they write this one. No, this is the person who discovered that ampere. So the SI unit, this one must be a small letter, and you say ampere, newton, volts. But if I say volts like this, this is the person who discovered that SI unit, then it will not be an SI unit, it will be a person. So we have said the potential difference, as which is defined as the work done to move a charge from one point to another in a circuit, is what you call potential difference, and it's measured in volts. The question would be, how can we define this word volt? The way we have defined an ampere is the way we can define this one. We can define a volt as the potential difference when a charge of one coulomb is moved, or when work is done, when electrical energy is done of 1 joule and moves a charge of 1 coulomb within the circuit. We are saying you must say work done, or electrical energy of one joule moves a charge of 1 coulomb in the circuit. So we define a volt as that work done, or is electrical energy, volt is potential difference when electrical energy of 1 joule produces a charge of 1 coulomb within a circuit. That's how you can define the SI unit of potential difference, which is termed as PD. Now, to move from this, we want to see something else also, which is number 3, and that is none other than electrical resistance. Electrical resistance. In some books, we find they call what? Resistance. What's resistance? And its symbol is always R. The resistance is defined as that opposition to the flow of current, not the position of all flow, it is to the flow. The opposition to the flow of current is none other than resistance of a conductor. If you have a conductor, something like this, you have current moving, and this is a barrier stopping this current to go through this one with ease. The current must be at B. It's moving from A, it's going to B. And the current has failed to reach at B because of this thing which is in the middle. With this thing will be termed as a resistor, which is say it has resistance and is opposing the flow of current within a circuit. Now, from Ohm's law, which states that the potential difference across a conductor is directly proportional to the current flowing, provided temperature and other physical conditions are constant, we shall have from V equals to IR, When I divide by I, I get my V equal, R equals to V out of I. The V is the potential difference that is measured in volts, whereas I is current measured in ampere. Therefore, the SI unit will be volts per ampere. And 1 volt per ampere is equal to 1 ohm. Therefore, the standard SI unit of resistance is none other than ohm. And we can even define ohm. What's ohm? Ohm is the electrical resistance when a PD of 1 volt supplies current of 1 ampere within a circuit. I'm saying resistance, ohm is the resistance when a PD of 1 volt supplies current of 1 ampere within a circuit. Now, from this, after seeing all these ones, a question can be said. And they say, define the following terms as applied to electricity. Number one, they can say, define ampere. Define ampere. Number two, they can say, define volt. Number three, they can say, define ohm. Number four, they can say, define resistance. Number five, define current. And number six, define potential difference. Please be careful. These questions can be set, and it's upon you to know how they can be answered. Number one, ampere is defined as the electric current which, when flowing in two straight parallel wires of length L, placed 1 meter apart, produces current of 2 exponent negative 7 Newton per meter. Whereas volt is defined as, volt is the potential difference when electrical energy of 1 joule produces a charge of 1 coulomb within a circuit. Whereas this one is defined as that ohm is the resistance when a PD of 1 volt produces current of 1 ampere. Resistance is the position to the flow of current within the circuit of a conductor. Current is defined as the rate of flow of charge with time in a section of a conductor. Potential difference is defined as the work done to move a charge from one point to another within a circuit. Now, from this, one to look at theory of metallic conduction. Theory of metallic conduction. In other words, how conductors do work. Remember, conductors is occupied by electrons. We have said it before that the medium of particles in graphites and metals is all about electrons. These are electrons which are inside what? A conductor. Now we are going to see if a conductor is composed of electrons, how do they behave? These electrons have what you call thermal energy, depending on temperature difference. Temperature difference. Electrons inside a conductor, they have what you call thermal energy. The moment there is a temperature difference, this is 20 degrees Celsius, the other is 30. Electrons must move, must vibrate. So because of this temperature difference, we're going to consider a situation whereby you have a conductor. This conductor, we are going to take a conductor of area A. We are going to take a small sample of this conductor, though it is here. This conductor, I have said, is occupied by electrons. And electrons, assuming they are moving, going this side. Whenever PD is supplied on this conductor, what will happen? These so-called electrons will gain kinetic energy, but produced by what? By heat, which is obtained from electric field. Why electric field? As these electrons are moving, going this side, they are leaving a high concentration of positive charges here as they are going the other side. Because as they are moving, going this side, they create what you call a negative charge on this side. This is a positive, this is a negative. Therefore, there must be electric field created there. Because of this electric field, these so-called electrons will regain what you call kinetic energy. Are they gaining kinetic energy? It means they will start to move. In other words, the speed has been increased. Because kinetic energy is always given as a half mv squared. It's all about this v, which is termed as drift velocity here. As these electrons are moving going this side, they collide with one another. As they are colliding with one another, they lose what you call kinetic energy to the neighbors. Whenever they lose kinetic energy, some electrons, of course, will persist and move. And those that will move with what you call average speed, that will constitute what you call current, moving in opposite direction. So we are saying, whenever PD supply, these electrons, or the conduction electrons, they gain heat. Once they gain heat, they gain what you call kinetic energy. As they are gaining kinetic energy, this is due to electric field created. As that thing happens, electrons are moving from one point to another. Therefore, we are saying they collide with one another. As they collide, they lose what you call kinetic energy to the friends. As they are losing kinetic energy, there are those that continue moving with an average speed, and those ones will move that continue with moving at average speed, they will constitute what you call electric current moving in opposite direction. And from that, by the way, you can even ask a question: how heat comes up? Heat is coming because we have electrons going the other side, we have current moving in opposite direction. There is friction. A case in point, get your two hands together. You combine these sums together, then you drag them like this. What will happen? You will hear heat. You'll feel heat coming up. Similarly, as these electrons are moving, going the other side, the current is moving, moving this side, they are moving in the opposite direction. They are colliding because of friction. At the end of the day, heat is generated. That's why sometimes when you are having like a percolator at home, you plug this percolator in the socket, you touch on the wire, when it's heating, you shall find this wire warming. It is warming because of that kind of friction that's coming up within this area. Now, from this, we have seen the situation whereby these electrons are moving. In other words, we want to prove the theory of metallic conduction, which is given as I equals to nav. How do we prove that? We are going to consider this so-called conductor of length L. This conductor has area A. It has electrons E. This conductor has various number of electrons inside them. How do we get volume? How do you define volume, by the way? Volume is a space occupied by an object. Therefore, we shall get volume given as area times length. If this is volume, how do we get number of electrons within? Of course, number of electrons is given as Ne. Then how do we get total charge surrounding this so-called section of conductor picked as a sample? The total charge is given as, total charge Q is given as NaLa. If this is total charge, remember by definition, we have defined current as the rate of flow of charge within a section of conductor with time. Therefore, our I equals Q out of T. Can we make this Q the subject? Yes. Remember, I've said this is volume. These are number of electrons within this section of conductor. And this is what you call total charge of this section again. Now, if that's true, we shall have Q equals to I T. This is my first equation, this is my second equation. When I compare these two equations, I'll have my IT given as NaLa. Now, from this, I'll divide by T both sides. This will disappear. I'll have my I given as NaLa out of T. I have this scenario. There is L divided by T. When you have distance divided by time, what do you get? It's speed. Because we define speed as distance, the ratio of distance to time. Now it means we shall have our I given as NA, then E, L out of T. But L out of T, I've said, is velocity. Therefore, we shall have our I given as NA, VE. And this is the formula of electric current passing through a section of conductor. Catch me in the next episode. I remain at my Mzano from Zana. I've standardized from Zana.